Say to them, قُلْ. Say to them, لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. I do not ask you for anything. إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. Except that you love my family. You love those closest to me. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam is told by Allah to tell his people, لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. I don't ask for any reward from you. I don't ask for anything in return from you. I don't ask you to pay me. لا أسألكم عليه أجرا. I don't want no أجر from you. What's understood from this is, every Nabi and Rasul, Allah Almighty will give them. And the Anbiya and Rusul used to say, many a time to their people, that we don't want nothing from you. All that was demanded from the people was that they believe in one Allah and they believe in that specific Nabi and Rasul. So the Prophet ﷺ is saying, I don't ask you for anything. I'm not asking for any reward. I don't want nothing. Allah is the one who is the best of providers. Allah is the one who has given me everything. So I don't ask you for anything illa, except. There's an exception to this statement. I only ask you al-mawaddata fil qurba. Al-mawadda. Mawadda in the Arabic language is a synonym of the word mahabba. Hub and wad, both in the Arabic language, mean love. In English, it's quite simple. You would say, I love you, and that's it. But in the Arabic language, to express love, there are a number of words and number of ways. This is why Arabic is such a beautiful language. There's not only one way to tell someone how to do something or how they feel. Different words have different meanings. But generally, the words mahabba, mawadda, ishq, these are synonyms that all in English are translated as English, as love. Mawadda is that type of love which is unconditional. It's an unconditional type of love. Hub is general type of love. Ishq is a lustful type of love. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, I don't ask you for anything except that you have unconditional love fil qurba. For who? The closest to me. Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam was asked a question then. Man karabatuka ya Rasulullah? Who are the closest to you? Who are the close ones that Allah is talking about in this verse that you are mentioning? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, Fatima and Ali and their two sons, these are the closest to me. I love them more than anything. I love them more than everything. I love them, so all I'm asking you to do is love them. A sign of iman, complete iman, is love for the Ahlul Bayt, the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. It is fard upon us to love them. In another ayah of the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah Almighty said, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. Allah Almighty intends to remove impurity from the Ahlul Bayt, the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَيُطَهِرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا, and He intends to purify you the best of purifications. The Ahlul Bayt. Here Ahlul Bayt is mentioned. Sayyidah Salama asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is the Ahlul Bayt? Am I one of them? Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, you are from my wives. And the wives of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam are from the Ahlul Bayt. We believe the wives of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the Ummahatul Mu'mineen, the mothers of the believers, they are also considered part of the Ahlul Bayt. This is the correct opinion. But Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam specified and said and called Sayyidah Fatima and Sayyidina Ali, Imam Hassan and Hussein, the Ahlul Qisa. They took off the blessed cloak and they wrapped their family around them and said, Allahumma ha'ulai ahli bayti. O Allah, you talk about my house in the Quran, my family in the Quran. O Allah, be witness. These who are sat with me inside this cloak, these are my family.